What is the workout?
Ring dips, weighted ring dips, sets of five.
That's what we're doing right now, and then we're gonna do kind of the same thing we did before, an interval workout of, we're gonna use the new football bar for bench press and pull-ups.
The what bar?
That new bar we were just playing with.
What is it called?
Well, they were calling it the football bar. It's a bar that's got a bunch of different staggered hand positions. And it's better for your shoulders, safer for your shoulders, I should say.
How heavy is the vest?
45 pounds, so it's 20 kilos.
Why does it stick? I think they can carry anywhere up to 130 pounds.
Let's do it with that. Let's just change and do like more than 5 sets.
Okay.
Yeah. 5 each time, but.
Do like a. Well, we can do 8 reps.
Yeah, let's do
8.
Yeah.
8 might be better.
I haven't done lots of weighted dips on the rings. I usually use the
Matador. Yeah. I like this because it's so much more.
Yeah, it's harder.
Unstable, harder.
That's my CrossFit thing.
Yeah, and it's the finishing to the muscle up.
Yeah.
Staying tight. Like, I mean, the general thing when you get on rings, you have a tendency to wobble everywhere because you're very unstable. And so that'll kind of come from just practice. But controlling the movement up and down, not getting out of control, I think, on the way down. Nico's got his chest just kind of on the outside, tilted forward, which I think is a good part of it. And then bringing the ring all the way down, so the top of the ring will touch at the shoulder for the full rep to count.
Mikko, do you use your chest, your triceps? What are you? Do you isolate it? Do you feel it being isolating muscles? Or?
I don't try to isolate, but I have stronger triceps than my chest. So when I'm like benching, like every second month when I'm doing my bench press, I always do it in a row grip. Like, I believe that's good for your split jerks and overhead strength more than chest. But that's like pretty narrow grip when your whole hands are like leaning to your body. So it's more like tricep than
Wait,
chest.
Say that again, what's a narrow grip?
If you're doing dips with rings, your grip is pretty narrow.
You want
to keep your hands close to your body, so it's more like tricep than chest.
And you were saying that that transfers over to what movements?
Olympic lifting, like getting overhead. So strong shoulders and triceps more than strong chest. Of course, it's like getting heavy overhead. It's more like speed thing. Not the, you gotta have strength on your like triceps and shoulders, but it's more like technique and speed. You can jerk 200 kilos with only being fast. You have to be strong.
Yeah.
That's why I can't do that.
Yeah.
So Dan Mikko was saying he feels it in his chest or in his arms, and you're saying you feel it more in your chest?
Yeah, I do. I feel ring dips more in my chest, or any kind of dip more in my chest than I would like bench press. Bench press, I feel like I use all my arms, you know? There's a guy here that works in our warehouse who's really strong at bench and just the powerlifting movements. And like once or twice a month, we'll we'll do bench, and he just kind of shows me stuff. Like, and it is like a big, more or less an arm movement rather than chest movement, I feel like. I think Louis said stuff about that, at least that's kind of where he's pulled it from. But yeah, I definitely feel my chest in this more than my arms. I mean, feel my arms too, but. This is called the football bar, am I not correct? Is this what it's gonna be called? So the hand positioning is different. Obviously, instead of being in this plane, you're turned on the inside. Basically, that's to help, I think, reduce some of the shoulder tension. I don't know a whole lot about it, because it's a new prototype, but.
Do you know about it, Chris?
It's a football bar.
Who designed it?
This is one of Louis' bars. So you'll find this over at Westside. It's kind of where it came from.
Have these guys ever used it?
Nope, this will be the first time.
I mean, I think part of the ploy with it is you have three different positions, so you can bench from three different spots, either the inner, the middle, or the outer. And each time you, I mean, this is just, I would imagine, each time you use those different hand positions, you're working different muscles, using a different type of, I don't know, different type of method to get the bar from your chest up, basically.
A more well-rounded workout?
Yeah.
How much does the bar weigh?
I think the bar weighs right around 80.
60, 70 pounds. We'll throw it on the scale after this.
All right.
Have you used this bar before, Mikko?
Never.
How often do you bench, Mikko?
like once every month, like once every 6 weeks, something like that. I don't bench a lot. It's a good movement, but I'm already tight from my shoulders and my upper back, so I don't want to tighten that too much. Let's put the 45s.
Yeah.
That's probably our weight in the
weight. Yeah.
And how often do you bench, Dan?
Probably once a month. Maybe twice a month. Before it wasn't even that much. Maybe. I don't know, I hardly benched at all, like through getting ready for the games and everything. I mean, pressing, shoulder pressing, all that stuff, kind of the same movement. I mean, you know, just the movement of a press. I think bench is probably good because you can actually, because you're supported by something, like you're supported by the bench rather than having your body hold up all the weight. You can train your arms at a higher intensity, like you can put more weight on the bar, but you have to push with your arm. And that would, in turn, I would think, develop, you know, strength to help in your press and those kind of things. But that's what I think. I don't know if that's necessarily true.
If you do 10 of those. Ten is quite a lot.
10 will be a lot.
10 bench presses with the football bar, 15 pull-ups, 5 rounds, intervals. So I'm doing the benches and pull-ups. Then is resting, and then we change.
How much do you think that bar is?
Probably
200 pounds.
200?
Yeah, something like that.
90 plus 70. I can't even do that in my head. 160 something, 170 something, I don't know.
And is that bar different, to feel different than a regular bar?
Yes, it does. It's a little bit more unstable. Like you really gotta actually try to really focus on keeping it straight from wobbling around. Yeah, in the wrist. Maybe a little easier on the press, to push it up. It just feels different. It feels like you got a little more leverage. But I don't know, we'll see. It'll be interesting.
I think 10 is quite a lot, so.
10's gonna be a lot.
Let's see what happens.
Going 10 to 15,
yeah,
the pull-ups are going to get hard too, even though it's a push and then a pull. I think it's still going to get pretty taxing.
Are we going to see the bar get stuck on someone?
Maybe. If you keep that camera rolling, maybe not. You might see somebody try to kill themselves before the bar comes off. Are you good?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Five, four, three.
even though it wasn't very long. You don't want to do that real often. I don't think you'd want to do that high intensity like three times a week. Would be a bad idea. To the point where you're like, I mean, I don't know about him, but on the runs back, I was like right at muscle, just failure. Like, I wasn't gonna be able to pull the sled. I don't think it's smart to do that like three or four times a week. Maybe not right now, later in the year. But
what do you think?
About the morning?
Yeah.
That was hard workout. Then the squats and then the sled. I mean, this one was pretty good though. So we train lower and upper body strength, short metcons. Tomorrow, something else. Different. Maybe some sort of like, now we had like pretty big weights still, like in the metcon. Maybe tomorrow, like lighter weight, more reps.
Yeah. If I were to do anything else today, it'd be like go for a jog or row, like slow pace, for like 20 minutes or something.
Will you do that?
Probably not today. This will be my third day on. And so if we're gonna work out again tomorrow, it'll be my fourth. Usually I don't go much beyond three, but because you're here and because Mikko's here, we'll definitely go tomorrow. Yeah.
Mikko, when will you do skill work?
I did like, what's today now, Saturday? I did on Wednesday, so I'll try to do once a week.
Only once a week?
Yeah, I'm like...
Shouldn't you do skill work every day?
Probably, I should. Yeah. I'm doing now like once a week, just only a skill session.
What's a skill day look like for you?
Handstand walks, L-sit. Like, I don't do like strict pull-ups or muscle-ups. I don't think that's a skill. Like, handstand walks, like I said, L-sits, something with the rings, stuff like that.
How about double unders?
That's not an issue for me anymore.
How about a muscle-up to handstand?
I can do that. So basically those are the skills I'm now focused on. And like every session I'm doing Olympic lifting, that's kind of skill session also to me. Skill to Olympic lifts with the lighter weight as a warm up. I try to do it like with my mind on the barbell and with good skill. So it transfers to the bigger weights also.